बुद्धं शरणं गच्छामि, धम्मं शरणं गच्छामि, संघं शरणं गच्छामि। We'll start with a small story. This session is from Zen Buddhism. A Jewish rabbi and a Christian priest both were staying opposite to each other. Not only they stay opposite to each other, they are opposite to each other. There used to be a continuous cold war between those two. The rabbi brings new rose garden to his house. You can be sure in 24 hours the same type of rose garden will be there in the priest's house also. If a priest paints his house by white in 24 hours, rabbi's house also will be white. A priest brings new TV, rabbi will have new TV. A rabbi brings new car, priest will have new car. One day, somehow rabbi managed to get a new Mercedes Benz. In front of his house, a new Mercedes Benz was standing. It is too much for the priest. Somehow, he put all his effort and brought a new Rolls Royce. Not only he brought a new Rolls Royce, every morning he was seen sprinkling holy water on the Rolls Royce. Rabbi came out and saw the whole scene and shouted, "Hey, you have got a new Rolls Royce, that's perfectly all right. But why are you sprinkling water on it? Till yesterday night you were all right. What happened to you now?" Priest said, "No, I am a religious man. How can I travel a car which is not Christian? So I am baptizing the car. I'm just baptizing the car." Now rabbi is in trouble. How to make Mercedes as a Jew? That day evening, rabbi was seen cutting the exhaust pipe of the Mercedes Benz by ox of fame. If you understood, if you have not, ask your next person. If you have not understood, ask the next person. So all these three could not understand. That is nice. She is trying to help you. When you compare and work, if you move through jealousy, you will end up only this type of foolishness. The energy center which we are going to work is Vishuddhi, throat chakra, throat center. It gets locked by jealousy and comparison. How many of you understood? Let me raise the hands. How many of you not understood? We will see. A very few percentage. Okay. Doctor could not understand. All of you are seeing that paper, throat chakra, throat center. It gets clogged by jealousy and comparison. Here, throat center, the chakra is there. The name of the chakra is Vishuddhi. Shuddhi means purity. Ashuddhi means impurity. Vishuddhi means beyond purity and impurity. Vishuddhi means beyond purity and impurity. This energy center is always alive and active. Only thing you have to use it. Now, as on now, it gets locked because of comparison and jealousy. If you compare with others and work, this chakra gets locked by the jealousy and comparison. When you understand your uniqueness and your immeasurable energy, this chakra gets opened. This is the chakra directly can be used in your life. This energy can be directly used in your day-to-day practical life. Let me explain the three layers of energy. Yesterday night I was telling you. We are habituated to attend a lot of intellectual classes. So we do not know what is spiritual process. It is not that something you learn from me. It is more, alchemy is allowed to happen in you. Step by step, alchemy is allowed to happen in you. If you see the meditations, step by step, you will be going deeper and deeper. Deeper and deeper. That is the reason the course is designed such a way you will not have a food at a so-called regular time. The time will be different. Sleep time will be different. Everything is gets everything is shifted. In India we don't even allow them to move out of the campus. They have to stay only in that area. Because once they go out, the mind starts thinking in a regular pattern. The continuity gets disturbed. I could see many to bring you back to this atmosphere energy again take lot of time. In India morning 6:30 so I start next session. Today morning 6:30 I start. And it's like a 36 hours program. I tell you, when you really go through the whole thing, you will never feel tired. Ask the people who danced yesterday, are you feeling tired? You will never see tiredness. Because tiredness is something to do with your mind. It is not at all an existence. There is no such thing as tiredness exists. It is just your mind. You can ask your body to rest, that's perfectly alright. But there is an idea mentally, tiredness, it never exists. It does not exist. When you understand this throat center and the three layers, you will be able to understand. See, meditation has become today bias market. In earlier, all this great science was seller's market. The master will choose. Now for the modern men, unfortunately, it's a buyer's market. Sit on the website, you will get 120 choices or 200 choices. That is the reason you couldn't spend at least 2 days. In In India, if somebody asks for exemption, just exemption, "No, Swamiji, can I go and come back to PRO?" They say, "No, you cannot be. Please don't come." That's only one word, please don't come. Because even if you want to enroll for ASP, you can enroll only through a healer. You cannot directly have a registration. Because it's more to do with the energy work. I say it's an alchemy process. We both of us together, we work on your energy centers. It's like a commitment. If you want to go, who is going to miss? I am not going to miss. All my energy centers are open. Yes.
Swamiji, I'm feeling very sick today. Heat, nausea. I'm wondering, will finishing the chakras help me, or should I go back?
Yes. No. Continue. I will heal you. If somebody feels sick, they can come after the session. They can raise the hand. Now, as he said, you can tell me, "I'm here. Verily, you can be healed. Don't worry about it." For that reason, you don't have to move out. And moreover, when the energy centers are cleansed, sometimes naturally things go out, erupt out. Perfectly, you can let the thing process happen. And you will always see it only ends in good. It only ends in good. And India, there's one more problem. Even if they stay here, they will not run around or they will not involve themselves in the programs. Like Mughal kings, they will be just sitting and watching. Others dancing. Have you seen the pictures of the Mughal kings? They won't dance, but just sit and watch. I always tell them, "Mughal kings are all going to have body pain tomorrow morning." People who involve, they never have any problem. You have three layers of energy. I'll tell you a small incident from George Gurdjieff's life. One of the great enlightened man who lived in the West. A rare flower.
What did you say, Swami? The last name of the man?
George Gurdjieff.
Oh. Good sir.
Gurdjieff, one of the rare flowers, happened to the West. A revolutionary master. Whenever somebody goes to him for a meditation, he will tell them, "Dig a big pit for 10 by 10 by 10. 10 feet, 10 feet, 10 feet. You make a pit for 1 feet, 1 feet, 1 feet, then you will understand what it is." You will tell them to make a pit. You will ask, "What 10 feet pit has got to do with meditation?" Only for samadhi you need to build that. Only for guiding somebody you need to make that pit. Why are you asking us to make a pit? What meditation has to do with it? He says, "No question. Do it. If you want to do, or get out." Anyhow, person who wants meditation naturally will try. Once he finishes the pit, that is another, then only he will start his main drama. He will tell, no, "You are done in a wrong place. Close it and do it in another place." And important condition is no food, no water, no sleep. By the time they finish the first pit itself, they won't come out. If they come out at all, he will tell, "Please do the second also." Anyhow, if the person is really interested, he will go for the second. After finishing the second, he will be surprised. He used to tell, no, "I think according to Vastu, that is not right. Just now I discovered, please do it in the back side." But the disciples are writing the reminiscence. They say, once he trusts his words and go for the third pit, to dig the third pit, The third tweet will be over in 1 hour. Just in 1 hour. First will take some 6-7 hours. Second will take 3-4 hours. Third, only 1 hour. I am surprised. How it is possible? Guruji gives an explanation. Everybody, every one of us have got three layers of energy. First layer is the layer of energy which you use for everyday activity. Morning 6 o'clock you get up, by the time evening 6 you are tired, exhausted, you want to go for resting, you don't want to do anything more. That's the first layer of energy.